So, Braun Strowman is beating up Bobby Roode Jr. this week, huh? Okay. What is up, Humanoid Nation? So, I think I'm just going to start some new thing here. I'm going to do like some Raw and SmackDown reviews of what I think of these shows, because I'm just starting to go back and watching these shows again, because it's been a while since I've seen a full show of Raw or SmackDown, because there's been some times where it's just bullshit. Maybe it's because like the brand extension is bringing back the inner fan in me, because I like the brand, like I said before, I like the brand extension back in the day, not when it first started because it was full of holes and shit. Then when they actually fixed it and got it right, because like Raw took on Raw, SmackDown took on SmackDown, and once in a while they took on each other. And then there was the dying days of the brand, which was bullshit, but maybe it's just because the brand extensions come back and they are talking about this new generation of the new generation over times a thousand, because they kept on saying that old that shit. So, I'm going to start doing these from now on. So today's Raw review starts out with Sasha Banks coming out with all her hotness. Even though she can kick your ass, she is pretty hotness. She is that damn hotness. And then a bunch of other people come out, Charlotte, and then Enzo Amore and Chris Jericho. And they keep on talking. And talking. And then there's some like sexual innuendo going on between Enzo and Sasha Banks, which I'm thinking like, whoa, isn't this show rated PG-13? Yeah, this ain't PG-13. It's like, they're like Enzo Amore doing a whole Joey Tribbiani thing on Sasha, and Sasha's going with it. Like, it was cool seeing him doing that, but it was kind of weird. But yeah, and you're just waiting. It's like, when are they gonna announce a mixed tag team match? Because that's what they're gonna bound to do. And then you hear Mick Foley's music, and I'm going like, thank God, he's going to announce it. But no, he keeps on talking. Oh, shit. Come on, Foley. And I'm surprised Foley is wearing a tux or a suit, because Foley's not the kind of guy that would wear a suit. They got to him backstage. They got to, because that guy's a frugal bastard. He so is. So he finally announces a mixed tag team match between the two. And by the way, doesn't Enzo Amore remind you of that kid back in elementary school that was never in his seat and was always running around doing things? But although Enzo is entertaining, it's like, yeah. And Chris Jericho walking around with his hand like this, kind of disabled. It's like, what is this? Is this I guess it's supposed to make people pissed off at him because he's a heel. But it kind of makes him look kind of disabled a little bit. I'm just saying. And I can say that shit because I'm pretty much disabled. Like, I am on disability. Surprise! You got that, those of you didn't know, now you know. I'll tell you about that shit some other time. Okay. So, that match happened. And so much other stuff. Like, hey, Mark Henry came back, which was surprising. I haven't seen him in so long. Oh, yeah. Rewind. Before that. We got Braun Strowman taking on Bobby Roode Jr. Okay, moving on, and then he goes away. And then we see a backstage vignette of Stephanie and Mick talking about shit. And Mark Henry comes in and is like, hey, I want some competition. I want to be back. And I so thought they were going to set up Braun versus Mark at SummerSlam. This match is going to be bowling shoe ugly, like JR would say. And it's a good thing they never made that match, because then we got an even worse match. Mark Henry versus Rusev. Yay! I like Rusev. I really do. But against Mark Henry. Mark Henry's not that good. I still don't understand why he's around. My God. So yeah, Mark Henry comes out, and I gotta say, that guy lost a lot of weight. Come on. He does look like he has less of a stomach. He still has some upper body muscle, but his stomach is less? And then we got a 5-star match of just boring shit. Like I said, it's cool to see Mark Henry back, but I don't really want to see him wrestle. Whatever he's doing for the Olympics. He's an ambassador, right? Yeah, he's an ambassador. Yeah, so that happened. Rusev took on Mark Henry. Then we got Finn Balor talking to Seth Rollins. And the WWE is making the whole point of saying, like, these guys have never fought ever before. I'm pretty sure if you do your history or YouTube this, you can pretty much find a Tyler Black versus a Prince Devitt match somewhere. I was looking on YouTube before I did this, before I started doing this video, to see if there's some kind of match out there. There isn't, but there's bound to one pop up one day out there. Because, yeah, these guys have fought before, I'm pretty sure, or not. Correct me if I'm wrong. So, yeah, Nia Jax come out, the beautiful, stunning, voluptuous Nia Jax. Yes, I like the big girls, sue me. Takes out and comes out and just squashes some jobber lady. Moving on. We got a bunch of bullshit. Then we have Heath Slater coming out. Oh, for fuck's sakes, Heath Slater. Still playing an idiot. But I'm surprised they brought back Jinder Mahal. Where has he been? He hasn't been anywhere. It's like he's a regular indie guy in my side of town, because I always see him in these PWA shows I always go to. This just came out of nowhere. You never heard of Jinder Mahal coming back. Sure, he's a hometown boy. I like him, but where the fuck did he come from? Well, he's not a hometown boy, but he does wrestle a lot here in my hometown when he's not under WWE contract and shit. Because he pretty much worked for here. The Rupakangi Vice. Kariachi Vice, what am I talking about? Look up the Kariachi Vice on internet. Him and Tiger Raj Singh, I forget the other guy's name, but they're a pretty good tag team. What's the best theme song ever? The Kariachi Vice. I love that theme song. It's Middle Eastern. Of course it's Middle Eastern. It's a Kariachi Vice. So from one idiot to another idiot. Really? I just can't get over the fact that Heath Slater is just that bad now. Yeah, but like I said, from one idiot to another idiot, Goldust. Well, not Goldust. R-Truth. Why are you still playing a massive moron? Can we stop with R-Truth being a massive moron and take him seriously? Please? No? Because Vince McMahon doesn't like black champions and Rock is Samoan, so that doesn't count? Him playing Pokemon while Goldust got beat. I like Goldust's new look, though. It was pretty awesome. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention that I guess Roman Reigns got demoted now that he's taking on Rusev for the U.S. title, so I guess that's a match set for SummerSlam. Gee, how the mighty have fallen. Roman Reigns getting demoted. But who knows where that will go. It'll probably be good or some shit. I don't know, it's Roman Reigns. I'm just glad he's not taking on for the title. Don't get me wrong, I don't mind Roman Reigns. He just doesn't wrestle that great. Yeah, it's like, I don't mind him coming out. It's just, I just regret him wrestling, if that makes any sense. Yeah. I don't know where I'm going with that. So, to end the show, we have Brock Lesnar coming out, and Paul Heyman just basically doing all the talking. And Paul Heyman, he's so fucking awesome at talking. Man, I could just listen to that guy talk for hours. And then Randy Orton comes in and just RKOs Brock out of nowhere. Which was, I gotta say, it was surprising as shit. But come on, please, when SummerSlam is over, can we stop having Raw and SmackDown people showing up on each other's show? Because that was a major problem during the brand extension during the first time. Because we're like, remember, King of the Ring, Undertaker versus Triple H, the match was over, and then, well, who was on what? Undertaker was on Raw. Triple H, I forget, it's been so long. One of them was on Raw, one of them was on SmackDown, is what I'm saying. And then, like, Triple H shows up on Raw or on something. Or was it SmackDown? I can't remember. I just know it happened. Yeah, the match is over, the feud is over, yet they're still continuing it. The dark days. The fucking dark days. But yeah, Randy Orton RKO in an hour was amazingly surprising. Oh, I'm just jumping out of everywhere. I'm just jumping everywhere, because that's how my brain works. Because I remember things that happen at random times. Okay, New Day versus Luke Gallows and Karl Anderson. You know, before that match happened, they said, like, oh, we need one guy barred from ringside. And that was Xavier Woods, and they're saying, like, oh, because it's a disadvantage because we don't... Some bullshit that the Gallows and Anderson made up. And I was thinking the entire time, like, this is a trap. Somebody's debuting. There's going to be a new member of the club waiting to not take any advantage of that situation, man. Yeah, you were setting up to sound like someone's going to come out, but no. It was just Luke Gallows and Anderson just beating up New Day. And another non-PG era joke where, like, they have the banana. I'm just going with that. Oh, yeah, and Xavier Woods, man. By the time he went back up the ring, inside to the backstage, the match was already over, so what was the point of that? I'm just saying. So that's basically it, my Raw review for this week. If I missed anything, I'm sorry. Anyways, let's see what SmackDown has to offer for tomorrow. Anyways, take it easy, Humanoid Nation. Humanoid Freak out. Bye.